Are you curious how split screens are done? Or how this is done? Or these? Well, this is done by masking. Masking is, in short, only showing what you want to be shown in a shape, kind of like what you're seeing right now. It's kind of hard to explain with the abstract definition, so let's get practical. Cookie cutters are predefined shapes that you can apply onto cookie dough. Now this is a separate piece in this shape. Everything outside the cutter is separate, and we're only focusing on the now separated cut cookie. Let's put it into practice. To explain how to mask, let's try and do something. So we have this TV monitor, and we want to put an animation inside of it. So just plop some backgrounds and character animation beneath the TV sprite layer. You can see everything is spilling outside the TV, and this looks gross. But we can mask our animation to fit inside the screen portion of the TV. Make a layer above all of this, but behind the TV, and draw the shape you want the mask to be. We'll just use the rectangle tool. Remember, masks only work when the shape is a single, solid color. Right-click the layer and select Mask. You'll see an indentation appear, like this. Sort of like with guide layers. This means that the layer below is under the mask. We want all the animations here to be masked, so you just drag them under like this, so they're all masked. Doing it one by one is a pain, so just select the top one, hold shift, select the bottom one, and drag them all under in one go. You can hold control and deselect the ones you don't want to move, or to select any other ones not in the set. Now remember to lock your mask layer and the indentations, otherwise the mask doesn't show up on the timeline. And then boom! You've got a mask square with an animation contained inside it. Now let's try some other applications of masking. So the way this scene is set up is that this character sends the sandbag flying really far off screen, and we'll have a pop-up on the top right showing the sandbag flying. First, we already have the attack animation done. Now we start in the corner, here, and add a background and a symbol. We're gonna animate the background moving in parallax. We briefly went over this in our video about backgrounds. Okay, now we'll animate the sandbag flying around and slowing down to a stop. Alright, and the animation's done. To fix the background bleeding like last time, we set up our mask. Make a rectangle of a single solid color, place a layer on top of it, right click, mask, drag the layers underneath, lock the layers, and we're done. Let's make this more presentable though. Let's add a border with a glow and animate it transitioning in with a brightness tween from alpha 0% like so. Add a bit of stretching and there we go, a mask tween. Some animations may have characters who are kind of going from black to normal, like this. This doesn't technically require masking, but we figured we'd cover it here real quick. All you have to do is have a trace sprite, and on a layer above, copy and paste in place using Ctrl-Shift-V. Then highlight the sprite on the top layer, and apply a linear gradient from black 100% to black 0%, and use the paint bucket tool to drag how steep you want the gradient curve to be. There you go. Want to do a split screen? Have the animation on one side, and start working with the other side. Make a shape of the mask depending on how you want the split screen to look, whether it's a rectangle or an angled one. Mask and indent the layers, then add a white line with a glow to separate the mask, and there you go. Masking can be used in clever ways, like this building spin. That's masking. They got a flat, loop texture, added some gradients, and did some spinning via tweens. You can also do facial rigging if you've ever wondered how animators make their characters' eyes move around and how they do this thing with their face. That'll be covered later in this chapter when we do rigging. Another preview for you, I guess. In any case, that covers the basic applications of masking. Again, this'll be important later, so make sure you understand it now.